Yeah, we're gonna film you. You're gonna be on a movie. Movie star.
Siadasz, Unia?
No co ty będziesz w wózku siedziała?
A wasza Unia to gdzie?
Chodźcie tu wszyscy razem. Motorcycle. To jest teraz General, tak?
Ja wiem, to tych biletów już za dużo.
General. Sprawdziłeś, czy czyste? Czyste uszy? Może jeść. Smile. Tell her to smile. Tell her to smile, because she's gonna... Okay, cool.
But you know what? That's good.
No fight.
Munia! Munia!
No fight, that's it.
Board once again, everybody, to our motor safari. I'd like to remind you that you...
Very mistake. I make a
later on in the journey we go to the right
way in front
of the coming up on the right is the largest building in Brookfield, so one of the first of its kind ever built in North America. It's called Perfect World. You find most of the apes and the monkeys in three different rainforests.
This was the first special.
South America, the second Asia, mistake and Africa, is rains and thunders in every rainforest.
Probably I don't feel up well.
It rains on you out here.
I got a family going through the shower to the bathroom.
And to get to the entrance of Traffic World, you have to take this roped-in path we call a Frankie's Journey. And during your journey through that path, you'll learn more about rain. Next will be Arky, a Monica Kinnebuck, and I don't see... Well, sure, she is. She's by the pool. She hasn't gone in yet.
Sleeping by the pool.
Next, of course, will be Jimmy and Oxy, our Alaskan brown bears. They were orphaned when they were just cubs on Admiralty Island. They were able to survive,
but
able to capture them, had room for them here, brought them back from Admiralty. 8 years later, they weighed close to 1,000 pounds apiece. That's Oxy in the first pool. Let's see if Jimmy is in the pool here in the second enclosure up in the south, in the sunlight. On the right coming up is our traditional children's zoo. The one place in the zoo where you can actually touch some of the animals in the zoo area.
851.
A lot of domestic farm animals in the barn and surrounding barn. We're pulling into our east station. It's closest to dolphins. We'll let the wait here for a minute though. There's another tram. We have four shows on the weekend.
Bentheim and Kahn Dine.
And if you miss them, you still can see them down in the large
and
at the lower level.
Keep
in mind also, at that lower level, we have a free virtual boat ride. Take a motorboat ride with Randy Wells. He's a dolphin researcher. He's been affiliated with Brookfield Zoo for the last 30 years. His base is Sarasota, Florida. Take that motorboat ride out of Sarasota, Florida, in the bay to see some of the dolphins he's been researching. We're going to go into the Amur Tigers, the largest of the cats of the world. Tiger with the least amount of stripes. Adrian lives here with her granddaughter, Molly. They're probably trying to also find a cool place until the sun leaves their enclosure. They're probably in the alcoves in the back. Sleeping way over the far right. Sloth bears are insectivores. Sir, if you throw anything more at that exhibit, you're going to be out of here. You understand? You in the white shirt? Sorry about that, folks. We don't allow abuse of the animals here. There's Johnny, our African male lion, sleeping in the last enclosure. He sleeps 18 to 20 hours a day. He doesn't need to sleep that long here. Because he's fed every day. But if he were living in the wild, he'd have to sleep that long to conserve his energy. His hunting ratio and finding something to eat is extremely poor. Figure one meal every 15 times he goes looking for something to eat. How would you like to go to 15? Effie is our largest girl in here at 33. She's 11,000 pounds, and that's Christy at 22 at only 8,000 pounds. Let's see what the girls are doing when we get up there. The girls haven't been to Weight Watchers in a long time, but they could sign up. If you look at the end of their trunks, they have prehensile lips, flexible enough to grasp something as small as a fountain pen, but yet strong enough with 40,000 muscles in it to pull up a tree by its roots just to get to the leaves. And that's Christy in trying to dig in the mud right now. And, of course, in the water. They love the water. Next, of course, will be our African black rhino yards. We've had black rhino in Brookfield since 1941. We're the first zoo in North America to ever give birth to a black rhino in captivity. In this enclosure here, you get to see Kazuri. She's the last in a long line of rhino births here. She's met her mate by computer date. We belong to the Species Survival Plan, a computerized network cooperating between zoos. We place one rhino where they're best suited to mate with another. Her case, she's met that significant other, and she's going to a zoo in the east soon. Why do we belong to the Species Survival Plan? Because they're so very endangered. It's estimated there's only about 3,000 left in the continent of Africa. Still being poached and hunted to this day for their horns, which really aren't horns at all. Skin from sunburn. Hair on his body. He can get a sunburn as you and I can. And, of course, it's a great insect repellent. But if you saw him when he's fully bathed in the morning, after he gets out of his jammies, extra, extra large, it'd be a beautiful dark reddish-brown color. Then, of course, he'll coat that skin with the mud. The color you see is the caked-on mud to protect his skin. We're going up by Ibex Island, home to our Siberian Ibex mountain goats.
That is my sign.
These being the largest mountain goats in the world, they also have horns that grow up to 4.5 feet.
I feel sorry for you.
They have horns also. Look how much shorter. They're going around in this mountain like it was a flat playground.
Pumba. Pumba is
our oldest one in here, is the matriarch. And she's kind of taken the two younger ladies, Haley and Abby, under her wing, so to speak. Coming up on the right, you get a very good glimpse of Nkili, our black rhino over here. He's come out behind. On the right, coming up, is the exhibit for the pygmy hippo. Pygmy hippo is a smaller version of the River Nile hippo, only weighing 500 to 600 pounds. Gone in outside for his dinner, I see the door open. But Hansel and Wicket, a father and daughter team of river and isle hippos, only weighing a mere 7,000 to 8,000 pounds, are out, and they're out of the water, so you can actually see them for a change. Well, one of them is in the water, one of them is out of the water right now. They're the most aggressive and dangerous animal to humans. In Africa, they kill and injure more humans than any other animal does. They move faster than humans think they can out of the water. They spend most of their day. They're really ultimately recycling the dripping from their mouth and from their lower lip. They'll swallow up for an extra drink of water. We're going to be pulling into the West Station, to the North Station in a moment.
Come on, hop in. Come on, let's in. Get in. 뭐냐? 헐, 씹고.
Fin on their back in the left-hand corner of the pool. Now the dolphin's dorsal fin works just like the keel on a boat. It keeps the dolphin moving in a straight line, even at speeds up to 25 miles per hour. Well, last but certainly not least are the dolphin's large and powerful tail flukes. The dolphin's tail flukes do provide them with that strength and power. They're also able to use them to help them communicate and even use them to hunt and find fish. Well, one thing we want everyone to remember today is that even though dolphins spend their entire lives in the water, they are not fish. They're mammals, so they need to breathe air just like you and I. Although instead of breathing air through their mouth, they breathe air through their blowhole located on the top of their head. Well, dolphins are also able to use their blowhole to make a variety of different sounds. Listen carefully. On the top of their head. Well, we started off today's presentation showing you one look at their phenomenal power. If you're not yet convinced, we're going to give you one more display. Now, by pumping their tail flukes in an up and down motion, dolphins are even able to support their entire body weight across the surface of the water. If you don't believe me, take a look and watch as the dolphins tail walk. That these dolphins weigh well over 400 pounds each, so it does take a lot of strength and agility to pull that off. Well, now our trainers and dolphins work with one another in up to 5 training sessions each and every day, so therefore the dolphins are continuously learning new things. And in order to teach the dolphins a new behavior, our trainers come up with a training plan that involves many different steps. One of the first steps involves teaching the dolphins something known as targeting. It asks the dolphins to target any part of their body to a special tool known as a target pole. We can then use that target pole to show the dolphins where a behavior needs to take place and in which direction to move their body. Well, now we're going to place Kai in the spotlight, one of our male dolphins. We're going to see a new behavior that he's been working on. This behavior is a hunting strategy that's been seen off the coast of Australia. It's a behavior that's known as slide beaching. And Kai is learning to show this behavior. Take a look down in the far right-hand corner of the pool. Now, what occurs during slide beaching is dolphins will chase fish right on up to land. Grab those fish in their jaws and then slide right on back into the ocean. Let's hear it for Kai with slide beaching. You'll notice he is receiving a reward up there at the main island. That is the training method we use here at Seven Seas. It's known as positive reinforcement. What this means is when the dolphins respond correctly to what they've been asked to do, then they'll be rewarded with something they enjoy, such as a handful of fish, a tickle on the tongue, or even a rub on the head. So see if you can spot the many rewards they are receiving today. Well, many of the behaviors you are seeing are natural behaviors the dolphins need in order to survive. And one thing that all dolphins do need to do is hunt and find fish. And an adult dolphin may need to eat up to 35 pounds of fish each and every day, so they use a variety of different hunting methods.